Hello students, today I am going to discuss with you DC motor, how it works, its functionality, its construction and its working principle and where it has been used. So let me start here. This DC motor is a very important question here. It has been asked for 4 marks in a board exam 10th class questions. In your board exams, they mostly ask you whether it is of last year, previous year papers or any kind of paper you take it here. They will be asking you the very foremost question of DC motor. Its construction, at least its working principle, will be asked for 1 mark or 2 marks. So students, please concentrate here and learn DC motor, how it works. So when I start here by explaining you, so DC motor is a device which converts electrical energy into the mechanical energy. So you think, you see that the motors are being used it everywhere in our electrical appliances like fans, coolers, water pumps, etc. So there we use motors in order to convert energy from one form to another form. Also, this motor is converting our electrical energy into the mechanical energy. That means you are providing electrical energy to it and it is converting into the mechanical energy, right? So now the question is how it has been converting from electrical energy to mechanical energy. Why and how it is converting it? So let us find out this one. So electric motors have been used to run electric fans, washing machines, refrigerators, mixer, grinders and all these things. All these appliances, you use electric motors. Electric motors are commonly works on the direct current, so it is called as DC motor. Okay, so common motor works on the direct current. Fine. So this is the internal part of the DC motor here, students, which I have drawn here. So let us very fast understand how to draw this one and how to label it and what are the parts of this DC motor. So I am not going to discuss, or we don't have the outer part of the motor. For a practical view, you can observe the outer part of the motor at any time. I will be showing on the screen also. So whenever you go to the electrical shop also, when it opens up your electric fan, inside that you can see the motor, or else at any case situation when you get any chance of seeing internal part of the motor, refrigerators and all that, you can observe the motors inside it. Okay, so now let me start here by showing you the construction part here. So first of all, your motor contains one horseshoe magnet. See, this horseshoe magnet is a permanent magnet here, students. It's a strong magnet. So it contains north and south pole. Obviously, every magnet should contain north and south pole, whether it's a horseshoe, power magnet and coil, other magnets. Okay. So here it's a horseshoe magnet, where between this horseshoe magnet, there should be a coil rotating so that our motor functions here, right? So in order to draw a cylindrical circular shape like this horseshoe magnet, I have just shown it with this shape here. So north pole is here and south pole is here. Afterwards, I have drawn a rectangular coil here. This rectangular coil is been connected to a commutator split rings here, and then it is been connected to the brushes B1 and B2, and then again wire goes and connects to the voltage here. Right, students? Now if you just draw it and leave it, you are going to get only 1 mark. You are not going to get complete 2 or 3 marks for this diagram until and unless you don't label it, students, right? So first of all, you need to label it here. Current is flowing here. Just since it is electrical energy, it is converted to mechanical energy. So you need to show the direction of electrical energy. See, it shows direction from positive terminal to the negative terminal. It goes from the brushes to the commutators to the wire, rectangular coil, and again comes back to the commutators, to the brushes and to the battery or voltage. Right, now label this rectangular coil with ABCD here, students. Until you don't label the diagram, you are not going to get full marks for the diagram. Armature coil, you can write down split rings and carbon brushes. And this is the direction of the rotation of coil. This direction of rotation of coil, we will understand it now here, students. Once I explain you how to get this direction, then you will understand it. I hope you are very much clear with this construction, students. Very simple it is. Horseshoe magnet, a rectangular coil, and 2 split rings and carbon brushes, right? Split rings and carbon brushes, that's it, and a voltage. This DC motor diagram is very similar to the DC generator, which I'll discuss with you in the next video about AC and DC generator also. So this diagram is very similar to the DC generator diagram, but the only thing is that it is converting from electric to the mechanical energy. There it will convert the mechanical energy to the electrical energy, right, students? Fine. Now I wrote some statements here in order to understand much better to you, students. So, see here, students, to attempt this 4 marks question, you need to write down the principle, its construction here, and its working of DC motor. Okay, so let me start very soon here to explain you. A motor works on the principle that when an electrical rectangular coil is placed in a magnetic field and current is passed through it, a torque acts on the coil which rotates continuously. So torque means the force, okay? So the force which rotates something, right? So that's a torque acting on the coil which rotates continuously. So this force only allows the rectangular coil to rotate, okay? Now the question is how to find the direction of force, or in which direction the force is acting here, students, right? Now, coming to construction. Electric motor consists of a rectangular coil ABCD of insulated copper wire. Already, whichever I told you, students, you can write this part with your own, in your own words also. It's not required to write the same sentences. Fine. The coil is mounted between the curved poles of U-shaped permanent magnet. It's a U-shaped permanent magnet. The two ends of the coils are soldered permanently. Half rings S1 and S2. So here the two ends of the coil is connected to the half rings S1 and S2. Then it is connected to the brushes B1, B2, and this goes and connects to the voltage. In this way, you can write down, students. So now one more important thing is the function of the commutator rings is to reverse the direction of current flowing through the coil anytime the coil just passes through the vertical position. The function of the carbon brush is to make contact with the rings of the commutators and through them to supply the current to the coil, right? So function of the commutator is to make the direction of the current, reverse the direction of current, and function of the carbon brush is to make the contact with the rings. Because if we don't have carbon brushes here in the diagram, students, if we don't have carbon brushes, these commutators will, if it is directly connected to this wire, and due to 1/2 rotation also, it gets intermixed and it gets complexed, twisted among itself only, and it will be unable to rotate freely. So in order to have a free rotation of this coil, we are using this carbon brushes, okay? Carbon brushes is not having any kind of functionality of generating the current, important functionality. Only thing is, it is making these commutators to move freely, okay? And from here, the current passes without any kind of resistance also, okay? It passes freely. So that is the use of carbon brushes, fine? So working of DC motor, here students, I did not write the working completely to you. It is up to the students to write in their own words, but I'll just explain you how it works. On pressing the key and the current starts flowing through the carbon brushes and the commutators, right? Now come to the diagram, all of you students. Now look at the diagram very carefully, students. Until I explain you, don't move and don't move from your position. Just observe it, students, here, okay? So here I go. So students, if you can have any key here, so just press the key or have a switch here. So when you on the switch, the current starts flowing from the brushes to the commutators and it goes to the rectangular coil. Fine. So student, this motor, this rectangular coil, this part is kept vertically. Horizontally. It is not kept like this. If you can see this one part here, students. So it is not kept like this coil. Coil is kept in this way. Okay. So coil is kept in this way and the current is passing like this. Current is passing like this, right? So that means my coil is just into the book. It is just into the book, right? Now, I need to explain this direction of current and magnetic field and force. To get the direction of force, I need to use Fleming's left hand rule. Okay? Which rule I am using here? Fleming's left hand rule. Okay? So let me go on by explaining you Fleming's left hand rule. So Fleming's left hand rule, what it says, students, that if I have middle finger, index finger and thumb, so this becomes my force, thumb becomes my force, middle finger, so middle finger is my middle finger pointing the direction of the current, and this forefinger is pointing the direction of magnetic field, and this thumb is pointing the direction of the force. See a student, these three parameters should be perpendicular to each other and then only you can find the direction of force, right? So once again, thumb indicates the direction of force, this index finger indicates the direction of magnetic field, which I am folding it here to show you, and this finger indicates the direction of current, right? Force, magnetic field, current. In order to understand or make a trick on this to remember it, you can remember as a father, mother, child. Father, mother and child. That means F means force, M means magnetic field and C means current. Okay. Now in this way you can understand very easily. Father means force, mother means magnetic field and child means current. Okay. Fine. Now I am going to place this left hand on this coil and find the direction of force. Okay. Let me go here. So now magnetic field is in this way. Current is going upward. So my force direction will be downward. You can see here, students. my force direction will be downward. That means my coil will move downward at this point. That means at the side CD. Now tell me students, at the side AB how it is going? So yeah, so let me move here. So at the side AB, so if I keep my hand here, finger here, so this is my current. So my current direction is this way. Magnetic field direction is going this way. My force will be upward. So my force will go upward. That means the coil is going down. This side is going downward. AB side it is going upward, right? I think you understood your students, or once again shall I explain you. So let me explain you once again. At the side CD, since the current is going upward, so it will be in this way. So my force will be going downward, right? So at this side, my current is going downward here. So my force direction will be upward, right? So I hope you are understanding, students. So at AB side, it is force is upward, and at CD side, the force is downward. Now, let me again take this pad. So as in this way, it is going downward and upward, okay? So now, when it completes one half rotation, you can see here, students, when it completes one half rotation, don't mind, it is my children's snake ladder pad. So once it completes one half rotation, so AB will go to this side and CD will come to this side, right? So when AB go to this side, CD will come to this side, S2 will also go to this side and S1 will go to this side, right? Yeah, so there will be interchange of split rings, but there will not be interchange of brushes, B1 and B2, okay? And the current will be flowing in the one same direction only, as current will flowing in the same direction only, right, students? I hope you are understanding till here, right? Now, when the coil came to, AB came to this side and CD went to that side, if you can draw it again, students, you can draw this one more half rotation at one more side, and you can explain it with the sides AB and CD. Now, when it goes to AB side here, again, this force will be going downward, right? And at this side, it will go upward, right? So, again, it will go downward, and it goes to upward. Clear? So, now, the coil will complete its one full rotation. The coil completes its one full rotation. What about the current direction? The current direction will be always same direction. In this way, it maintains a continuous flow of current. There will be one situation here, students. When the brushes comes in the contact with between these two gaps. If I show the 3D picture of it in the screen, you can check it, students. When it comes in this gap, obviously there will be a stoppage of current. That means current stops flowing. Because the contact between the brushes and the commutator stops here, yes or no? So when contact between commutator and brushes stops at this gap, there will be no flow of current. There will be no flow of current, no flow of current, right? So when there is no flow of current, then this commutator coil also may not move, right? Because of this current is flowing only, there is a force applied on this, and due to that, this coil is rotating. But when there is no current in this coil, then how will this coil rotate? Students, here when the coil started rotating, it had gained momentum. Now when it comes at this position here, so due to its initial momentum, it will start rotating slightly so that it comes again in the contact of this commutator. So once it comes in the contact of this commutator, again the current starts flowing. So once the current starts flowing, so again the coil gets its torque and momentum, and then it starts moving more faster, and it maintains this constant current. Okay, that means there will not be any problem if the carbon pressures comes in this gap of these commutators, right? So that only thing is, there will not be any flow of current at that point of time. Once it slightly comes in the contact of this commutator, slight contact, as soon as it comes from it in this contact, then the current will again starts flowing, right? Yeah. So students, this is the working principle of the complete DC motor. I hope students you understood here how this DC motor is working here. So it works, starts working in the direction of the rotation of the coil is anti-clockwise here. So your work is, students, I request you to interchange these polarities. That means minus let it come here and plus let it come that side. And then check the direction of the coil, how it is rotating, just for your practice purpose. Okay, students, draw the diagram again and practice it by yourself. I hope you understood this video today, students. Thank you, students. Thank you for watching. And please share it and subscribe the channel so that I can make more and more videos on this physics subject to you all students, so that you can get a help from these videos. Thank you, all of you. Thank you.